So, are you trying to monitor the urban trees? Want to track mortality or survival rates? We're going to review some fundamental components to urban tree monitoring, recording mortality status.
Isn't that easy? Just call the tree alive or dead.
Not quite. You may think a tree is either alive or dead, but often it's not that simple. Things are a bit more nuanced, and that's what we're here to talk about. So trees have this amazing ability to bounce back after near-death experiences. So we have to be careful when recording mortality information. Trees can be almost dead, but actually still alive, and they may seem dead in 1 year and then come back to life in another year. Trees can be cut down to the stump, but have new sprouts. And that's why we need to carefully consider how to record mortality status. The mortality status variable is considered a core part of any project that seeks to monitor change over time in our urban forests. Recording mortality status accurately is absolutely critical to urban tree monitoring studies. If you want to understand the mortality of trees that you plant or manage in a city, town, or suburb, mortality status should be the centerpiece of your data collection.
I've heard some planting programs reporting mortality or survival rates as a way of talking about the performance of their programs.
Some other practical applications of mortality studies are to figure out why the trees have died, generate a list of trees that need to be replaced, or give feedback to a property owner. Each of these objectives depends on accurately recording the status of a tree. Tree managers might also be doing a repeat inventory of all of the street trees in a particular city or neighborhood and wondering whether new plantings balance out trees that have been lost.
All right, you've convinced me that this is an important part of urban tree monitoring, so what do I need to record?
Great question. Let's get into the different categories within the mortality status variable. The mortality status of this tree is alive. But that's fairly obvious because it has green leaves.
So what about trees that are extremely unhealthy and might even look like they're dying?
Whoa, they're not dead yet. Extremely unhealthy trees, such as those with no leaves, but live buds or green tissue under the bark, are included in the alive category.
But I thought that we could lump dead and dying trees together.
In our urban tree monitoring field guide, we purposefully consider dying trees to still be alive. This is because sometimes those very unhealthy trees can bounce back in the next season. And because trees are not categorized as standing dead until they are all the way dead. We can call a tree standing dead when it has no green leaves, no live buds, no green tissue under the bark. Standing dead trees are also supposed to have an intact trunk and be more than a foot tall. Shorter than a foot, we call it a stump.
So, what would you say we have here?
This tree has a dead trunk and branches, but it has a few green sprouts shooting out from the base of the tree. We would still record this as standing dead, because if the sprouts continue to grow, they will form essentially new trunks different from the ones we've been tracking to this point. A new trunk means a new tree, which means a completely new record in the database.
Well, this one seems easier. It's a stump.
Correct. Now you're getting it.
Okay, but what about trees that are missing or removed? I should call those dead, right?
That's a great question. We're actually not going to call missing trees dead. Let's say you're doing a monitoring project and checking on trees from a planting program. You've got the address and other location information that's telling you there should be a tree in that spot. So two categories can apply here. It might take some sleuthing to figure out if the tree was removed or never planted. Both categories require that there's no sign of a stump or a standing dead tree. If a tree has been removed since the previous observation at that spot, you can categorize it as removed. If a tree was designated to go into the ground but never made it, it's listed as never planted. For example, maybe this address was on an original planting list, but on the day of the planting, the homeowner didn't want that tree, or maybe there was an unexpected problem with utilities under the ground. A final category in mortality status is unknown. Sometimes trees are inaccessible due to property access or construction, or maybe the location information is not good. It's hard to tell which tree is part of the study. Careful notes should be taken to explain what happened so that the project supervisor can decide how to deal with this tree when it comes time to analyze the data.
Okay, I see. Recording mortality status involves a lot more than simply a dead or alive. What are all those categories again?
Oh, this is a test. The categories are alive, standing, dead, stump, removed, never planted, and unknown. Okay, let's recap. In this short video, we touched upon only one element of urban tree monitoring, recording mortality status. But there's so much more to learn if you want to run your own monitoring project. For more tips, check out the links below, and thanks for watching.